In this video, we're going to start the CUDA software, Infinite Algebra 1, free worksheet, graphing quadratic inequalities. Our directions for this entire worksheet are to sketch the graph of each function. Now, graphing quadratic inequalities is very similar to graphing linear inequalities. When graphing linear inequalities, we first graphed the linear equation and then determined whether it was dashed or solid based on if it was greater than or equal to or less than or equal to versus greater than or less than. And then, so once we graphed that line, then we picked a test point and shaded accordingly. We're going to do the same for graphing quadratic inequalities. We're first going to sketch that parabola, determining whether it's dashed or solid, then pick a test point and shade accordingly. Now remember the format ax squared plus bx plus c. If a is positive, our parabola opens up. If a is negative, our parabola opens down. The axis of symmetry is used in helping us plot in order to sketch. And the axis of symmetry is x equals negative b over 2a. So in number one, our a is negative 1. So we know this is going to open down. And b is equal to 0, since there is no plus bx. So for our axis of symmetry, we'll have negative 0 over 2 times negative 1. However, 0 divided by any number is 0. So x equals 0, or the y-axis, is our line of symmetry. So we know our vertex is going to lie on that line of symmetry. So making our t-table, our xy table, where y is negative x squared, we're going to plug in 0 to start so we know where our vertex is, which in this case is a maximum. So 0, negative 0 squared is simply 0. So 0, 0 is our vertex. Now let's see when x is 1. When x is 1, we'll have the opposite of 1 squared, which 1 squared is 1, so we'll have negative 1. So then when we're at 1 in the x direction, we're at negative 1 in the y direction. However, remember that axis of symmetry, that point is reflected, so at negative 1 in the x, we're also at negative 1 in the y. Now let's look at when x is 2. So we'll have the opposite of 2 squared, which is the opposite of 4, or negative 4. So when we're at 2, we're at negative 4 in the y direction, and same for if we're at negative 2, we're at negative 4. Because of that axis of symmetry, those points are reflected. Now, I'll draw my line. However, this is where the inequality is important. We have greater than, not greater than or equal to, so we're going to connect these with a dashed line or a dashed curve. So there is the line that represents the parabola y equals negative x squared. However, now we need to use our test point, but we can't use 0, 0 since 0, 0 falls on that line. So let's use 0, negative 1. So plugging in 0 for x and negative 1 in for y, we'll have negative 1 is greater than the opposite of 0 squared. Negative 1 is greater than 0. That is not true. So we're not going to shade in the region that contains that test point. Instead, we're going to shade in the region outside of that test point. And that's our answer in number 1. Moving on to number 2. Our a is equal to 3, so this parabola is going to open up, and our b is equal to 0. So for the axis of symmetry, knowing that b is 0 and x is equal to the opposite of b over 2a, we know that since b is 0, that 0 over any numbers, 2 times 3 in this case, will be 0. So the axis of symmetry, again, is the y-axis. So our vertex falls on that y-axis, which in this case is going to be a minimum. So x and then 3x squared, plugging in 0 in for x, we'll find our vertex at 3 times 0 squared, which is 3 times 0, which is equal to 0. So again, 0, 0 is our vertex. Now looking at when x is 1, we'll have 3 times 1 squared, which is 3 times 1, since 1 squared is 1, and that equals 3. Set positive 1 and negative 1 for x, because that axis of symmetry, we're at a positive 3. And then next, we'll look at when x is equal to 2. That's 3 times 2 squared, which is 3 times 4, which equals 12. So when x is 2, y is 12, and because that axis of symmetry is the y-axis, when x is negative 2, y is also 12. Now I'm going to draw a curve to connect these points, and because it's greater than or equal to, that means it's going to be a solid line because any points that fall on that line hold true for the inequality. That's why it's a solid line. So there roughly is my parabola, and now I'm going to pick a test point and determine whether I'm going to fill inside of the parabola or outside of the parabola. So picking a test point, let's pick 0, 2. So plugging 0 in for x and 2 in for y, I'll have 2 is greater than or equal to 3 times 0 squared, which is 2 is greater than or equal to 0, which is indeed true. Therefore, I'm going to be shading inside of my parabola. And that's my solution in number 2. In number 3, I'll have y is greater than 2x squared. So a is a positive 2, so my parabola is going to be going up, which means my vertex is a minimum. And my b value, again, is 0. So I know that my axis of symmetry is going to be x equals the opposite of b over 2a, and if b is 0, that axis of symmetry is also going to be 0, which means my axis of symmetry is that y-axis. Now, making my t-table for x and y values, I'll have x, and then y is 2x squared. So if I plug in 0 for x, I'll find my vertex, which is 2 times 0 squared, which equals 0. So my vertex is at the point 0, 0. Next, I'll plug in 1. So that's 2 times 1 squared, which is 2 times 1, which is 2. So when I'm at 1 in the x, or negative 1 in the x because of that axis of symmetry, I'm at 1 in the y. Next, I'll look at when x is 2. That's 2 times 2 squared, which is 2 times 4, which equals 8. So when I'm at 2 in the x, or negative 2 in the x, I'm at 8 in the y. So 2 to the right of that axis of symmetry, I'm at 8, and 2 to the left of that axis of symmetry, I'm at 8 again. Now because this is greater than and not greater than or equal to, I'm going to be using a dashed curve to connect my points for my parabola. Now I need to determine if I'm going to shade inside or outside of my parabola. So I'll pick a test point that's inside. Let's pick 0, 1. So plugging in 0 for x and 1 for y, I'll have 1 is greater than 2 times 0 squared, which 1 is greater than 2 times 0 squared is 2 times 0, which is 0. And yes, indeed, 1 is greater than 0. Therefore, I'm going to be shading in the region that contains my test point, which will be the inside of my parabola. And lastly in this video, I'll go over number 4. Before I go over the answer to number 4, go ahead, click that like button, and subscribe to my channel. Now for number 4, our a value is a negative 2, so we know our parabola is going to be opening down, like a frown, and we're going to have a maximum. Our b value again is 0, so that axis of symmetry falls on the y-axis. X equals 0. Now for my t-table, x and negative 2x squared for y, I'll plug in 0 to find my vertex, which negative 2 times 0 squared is equal to 0. So 0, 0 is my maximum. Now let's look 1 to the right. 1 to the right of that axis of symmetry is x equals 1, so I'll have negative 2 times 1 squared. Negative 2 times 1 squared is negative 2 times 1, which equals negative 2. So when I'm 1 in the x, I'm at negative 2 in the y, and because of that axis of symmetry, negative 1 in the x, I'll also be at negative 2 in the y. Now let's look at 2. Negative 2 times 2 squared equals negative 2 times 4, which equals a negative 8. So when I'm at 2 in the x, negative 8 in the y, and when I'm at negative 2 in the x, I'm also at negative 8 in the y. Since both are a distance of 2 units in the x direction from that axis of symmetry. Now I'm going to need to draw my curve to connect these points, and that curve is going to be a solid curve because this is greater than or equal to. So there is my parabola. Now I'm going to use a test point, and I'll use a test point that's inside of that parabola. Let's use 0, negative 2. So plugging in 0 for x and negative 2 for y, I'll have negative 2 is greater than or equal to negative 2 times 0 squared. That's negative 2 is greater than or equal to negative 2 times 0. So negative 2 is greater than or equal to 0. That is not true. Therefore, I'm going to be shading outside as opposed to inside where my test point lies. And that's my final solution in this video. Join me in the next video where I'll finish this worksheet completing the second page, numbers 5 through 8. And if you haven't done so already, like, subscribe, and share.